Yes, we are going to be looking at the combined gas law so that we can derive the general gas law or general gas equation. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
The combined gas law is simply the combination of the Charles law and the Boyle's law. Combination of what and what?
Charles law and Boyle's law.
For you to completely describe any gas, you have to identify and relate four quantities. Identify and relate how many quantities?
Four quantities.
Number one is the pressure of the gas, the temperature of the gas, the volume of the gas, and the amount or number of moles of the gas contained therein. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So we say that a gas sample is described completely by four quantities: temperature, pressure, volume, amount of gas. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
And we know that Boyle's law says that volume is inversely proportional to pressure, and Charles' law says that volume is directly proportional to what?
Temperature.
Combining these two, you write your V. V is common to both of them, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
It's directly proportional to T is on top,
yes,
and V is below, is it not?
Yes, sir.
Introducing constant K so that you can remove this proportional sign. You have V equal to KT over P, is it not?
Yes, sir.
Now, BV is equal to KT when you cross multiply. So that you're making K the subject, you have PV over T equal to K, is it not?
Yes, sir.
Removing K and introducing second part of this, you have P1V1 all over T1 to give you what? P2V2 all over what? T2. This is known as general gas equation. This is known as what?
General gas equation.
Yes. In subsequent classes, we'll be learning an ideal gas equation, which we will introduce this third one, this fourth one known as N. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
But for now, we'll stop at the three. But we'll use the four quantities to describe the gas in future.
Yes.
No, to solve a problem now, we have a mass of oxygen gas occupies a volume of 2 times 10 to the power of 4 cm cubed at a pressure of 1.101 times 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter squared and temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. Calculate the volume when the pressure is increased to 1.35 times 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter squared and temperature changed to 43 degrees Celsius. How do we solve this? So I'm going to quickly clean up this. I'm going to quickly do what?
Clean up this.
This, so that I can solve this. So I said, whatever you want to solve, you start listing what the thing that we are giving.
Yes.
Volume is the first thing. So we have V1
equal
to what?
2 times 10 to the power 4.
Equal to 2 times 10 to the power 4 cm cubed. What is the next thing that was given? P1, pressure. P1 equal to what?
1.01
times 10 to the power 5. Newton per meter.
Yeah.
Then what is the next thing given? Temperature, is it not?
Yes, sir.
T1 equal to what? 27 degrees Celsius. To convert it to absolute, you have plus what? 273 to give us what? 300 K. Always convert to absolute temperature. Is that clear?
Okay.
Because Charles law stated in absolute temperature. Now, what is the next thing that was given? Increased to pressure. Pressure is increased to this. So P2 is now what?
1.35
times 10 to the power 5 newton per meter squared. And temperature change, so T2 equal to what? 43 degrees Celsius plus 273 to give us the, add 43 to 273.
316
Kelvin. So that's what we have. So we're going to put this in this equation. V1, T1 all over this. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is our P1? 1.01 times 10 to the power 5. What is our V1?
2 times 10 raised to
the power 4. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
All over. What is our T1? 300. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Equal to, what is our P2? 1.35 times 10 raised to the power 5 times. What is V2? We don't know V2. That's what we are supposed to find. What is T2? 316. Can you see that?
Yes.
So how this is equal to this. So how do you make the marker that is red and I don't have it? How do you make V2 the subject of the formula? So to make V2, we now have V2. To be equal to, you cross multiply.
Yes, sir.
So you have, from here you can make V2 the form subject here. You cross multiply, you have P1, P1, T2. Can you see it?
Yes.
Everything here, P1, V1, T2. All over, everything that is with V2. So you have what? P2T1. Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
So you put it and solve that. So you can substitute now by saying, what is your P1? 1.01 times 10 to the power what? 5 times. What is your V1? 2 times 10 to the power 4. Is it not?
Yes.
What is your T2? 316. 316. Is it not?
Yes. Sir.
All this over. What is your P2? 1.35 times 10 to the power 5 times. What is your T1? 300. So multiply this out. You see the answer. What you get is the answer. Press this calculator out. Can you see this? 1.01 times 10 to the power 5 times 2 times 10 to the power 4 times 316. All over 1.35 times 10 to the power 5 times 300. So press it out. Anything you get is your answer. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
If you like this, please hit on the subscribe button. Thank you. God bless you. Mm-hmm.